So you want to know how much it costs to charge a Tesla? It depends a lot on where you are.
How much does it cost to charge a Tesla? In short, it costs around $12 to fully charge a Tesla Model 3 long range from 0%. That comes out to around $39 per month for the average American driver. Compared to the 1,200 miles the average American spent fueling their gas car in 2020, we'd say that's really good. But the true cost of charging a Tesla actually comes down to several variables. This video is going to explain exactly the variables that I just talked about, and we're going to explain how you can calculate Tesla charging costs for just about any situation. So without further ado, let's charge right into it. To calculate how much it costs to charge a Tesla, you need to know four key things. That's your Tesla's battery capacity, its range, how many miles you drive per month, and the electricity rate you're being charged. Let's explain what those variables are in more detail, starting with battery capacity. You can think of battery capacity like the size of your gas tank. This number, which we measure in kilowatt hours, depends on which Tesla model you drive. For example, the Tesla Model 3 Long Range comes with an 82 kilowatt hour battery. When we talk about range, we mean how far your Tesla can go on one charge. Like battery capacity, this also fluctuates on which model you drive. The Tesla Model 3 Long Range, for example, can go 353 miles on one charge. How many miles you drive per month is pretty self-explanatory. Just ask yourself, how many miles do I drive in a month? For reference, the average American drives 1,200 miles per month. Last but not least, we have electricity rates, which we measure in dollars per kilowatt hour. You can think of them like gas prices. They not only vary on where you are in the country, but also which station you use to charge your Tesla, whether that be your home, a Tesla supercharger, or a generic third-party charger. For example, 1 kilowatt hour would have a different price at your house than it would at a Tesla supercharger, just like the price of a gallon of gas would be different between an Exxon and a Chevron station. Since electricity rates vary so much, it's really important to pay attention to them in order to accurately assess Tesla charging costs. Let's run through some examples to see how costs can vary depending on how you charge your Tesla. In these examples, we're going to assume you drive 1,200 miles per month, meaning you're an average American driver, and we're also going to provide numbers based on the Tesla Model 3 Long Range, which has 353 miles of range and an 82 kilowatt hour battery. So let's start with how much it costs to charge a Tesla at home, which will probably save you more money than any other charging option. Assuming you have a Tesla wall connector, you can get 44 miles of range per hour of charging. For a Tesla Model 3 Long Range, that means you can fully charge it in around 8 hours. So remember we said at the beginning of the video, it costs $39 per month to charge a Tesla. We got that number by plugging in the average American utility rate, which is 14 cents per kilowatt hour, into our equation. So to get $39, we did $0.14 times 82 kilowatt hours divided by 353 miles of range times 1,200 miles per month. Again, the average American spent $131 filling up their gas car in 2020. For $131, you can charge your Tesla, your spouse's Tesla, and your neighbor's Tesla, all with enough money left over to buy yourself some drinks at Starbucks for the three of you. You don't have to do that, but what we're trying to say is you're gonna save a lot of money by driving a Tesla as opposed to a gas car. So, what if we charged our Tesla at a generic charging station? These include non-Tesla third-party stations from ChargePoint, EVgo, or Blink. Generally, you can expect a rate of around 21 cents per kilowatt hour. However, some stations charge on an hourly basis, or there might be no charge at all. Also, bear in mind that you might pay fees if you keep your Tesla plugged in while it's not charging. So, using the 21 cents per kilowatt hour rate, we get around $59 per month to charge your Tesla at a generic charging station. At a Tesla station, you can expect to pay around 25 cents per kilowatt hour. But there are some stations that charge per minute as opposed to per kilowatt hour, and you'll also pay if you keep your Tesla plugged in while it's not charging. So at the 25 cent per kilowatt hour rate, you can expect to pay around $70 per month charging your Tesla at a supercharging station. The main benefit of using a Tesla supercharging station is that they charge way faster than anything else. You can rack up to 75 miles of range in 5 minutes at a Tesla supercharging station. If you want an even cheaper way to charge your Tesla, look no further than the fastest growing electricity source in America. By that, I mean solar energy. Since a home with solar panels generates most of its electricity by itself, you could spend as little as 5 cents per kilowatt hour, and at that rate, you can pay as little as $14 per month to charge your Tesla. Imagine spending $14 per month on gas. Yeah, I'm going to be taking 2 vacations a year on that. So after reviewing all the possible scenarios, you can pay as much as $70 or as little as $14 to charge your Tesla per month. Of course, you'll pay more if you drive more than 1,200 miles per month, or if you live in a state with higher than average utility rates. We're talking to you, California. But this range should give you a decent assessment of how much you might pay. You should really plug in your own Tesla model specs and driving habits into this equation to see how much you'll pay for your exact needs. But regardless of what that is, you're more than likely going to pay less by driving a Tesla than driving a gas car. Wondering how much you'll save by switching to solar? Head over to our online solar calculator, which will provide you an estimate of your savings based on your zip code and your most recent utility bill. It requires no personal or payment information, and it's free to use. Head over to solarreviews.com/solar-calculator. We put the link in the description.